This thing is about the future of DevConf, not about the new location for DevConf or something. It's more about some legal background for DevConf, similar to what SPI is for Debian. I want something created for the DevConf stuff. I've made a few... Come on. I've made a few slides, but no Beamer, so just take it as points.
You can read it.
I just read it and tell what I have here. It's more notes for me. At the moment, DevConf is run by different people every year. There are people joining and leaving the organization. Mostly Stockholm is the one staying there. Holger for a few years, I've joined for this year. And so it goes on and off. We have multiple sponsors this year, I think 32, and have lots of monies that we get out. And every year we have a different legal umbrella for the conference, which also means that we have leftover money most of the times. I don't know the exact amounts, but there's leftover money in Helsinki, Finland, in Brazilian, and I'm sure there will be some leftover money here in Mexico too. So money for DevConf is spread far away over the world. And there's also unclear liability. What happens if something breaks down very badly? Who is responsible for that? At the moment, one could fetch the main organizer and get Stockholm into a prison. I think he wouldn't like it. And that's why I and multiple other persons are thinking about a legal umbrella for the DevConf things, which has at least a chair, a cashier, secretary, and substitutes for everything, like every normal thing has. So we have something defined, having bylaws, defining the rules, who can be a member, what can be done, where goes the money that we get, so we can point all the sponsors directly at that. And if you give us money, you see we will only use it for DevConf, something like that. It has also the benefit of limited liability for the different people doing things on DevConf. And we can have one bank account of its own for the whole thing, the central bank account where all the money goes. We will stay with a local bank account for the running DevConf because we need money locally. But after that is finished, one gets out a budget and gets the rest of the money back to the central account, which can be easily used for the next one. You also have the possibility of advanced financing, where you can have money after you are sure that you get it from the sponsors, and can have the money before it arrived on your bank account, so that things like travel sponsorship, where the money isn't there in time, or other expenses you have and you need to wait for sponsors, doesn't happen, because you can use the money after you have the okay from the sponsors, which makes you a bit more flexible and stuff. You could also go and get consulting for legal and fiscal issues. Like every year you have a budget to give out to the members or so, and can ask people that know their stuff and do that as business to help you with it, to make it easier. And I think it's also easier to cooperate with sponsors then, because it's not one random person or two random persons, one of the Debian developers asking for money, but it's a DevConf organization asking for the money, so it's clear who wants the money and what for. So the next one is Foo, because I do want to have an open discussion where the pros and cons of this plan to get an organization for DevConf could be.
I think I can add or correct some things first. Usually we have only minimal amounts of money left after DevConf. Last year we were able to plan very precisely because we had a much better understanding of what the budget would be like, and the money that we had leftover monies was mostly like money that we collected from bottles and from things like recycling bottles.
But still, you have some money left.
We did have leftover money because. because we didn't break any things which we budgeted for. We got back down payments from the dollar. So we had about around 7 or 6% of the total budget. That was the budget left over then.
10,000?
Yeah, about more or less.
Euros.
Yeah. Before in Brazil, we didn't have leftover money. The money that we had there in Brazil was there because the HP check couldn't be checked or cashed because in time we wanted to do it exactly like this year to reimburse people right away at the conference. And that didn't work because the check needed 45 days and we just got it shortly ahead of DEPCON. In Norway, we didn't have money after paying leftover bills at all, actually. So we came out of most DEPCON with plus minus zero. This one will be different because we weren't able to budget properly because of uncertainties regarding the local things, and because we mostly because that actually our main sponsors, well, we didn't get the receive the money from the main sponsor not so far, and for that reason we will have we had to cut our budget at some points and to save the money because we didn't have any to spend, but we will still get the huge amount of money that we get from that sponsor.
Who should not be named?
Yes. Hopefully we won't misuse our sponsor's money in the future for that,
yes,
either. Because we got it earmarked for DEPCON and we cannot.
Yes, I don't want to say that I do not trust those people that have the money at the moment, but I think it would be better to have it in a local account, so that maybe the money from Helsinki could be used for some payments in advance for this year, something like that for the next year, and stuff like that. And that you have one DEPCON account of the whole time where you have the complete budget over the whole. So stuff
that there are problems with that. For example, for Brazil that wasn't possible because Brazil has very strict rules for moving money in and out of the country. So far we
have a similar situation here that's also stopped us quite a bit.
I mean, we don't have the strict rules, but we are afraid because touching larger amounts of money opens us for investigation. And as we are running DEPCON on our personal account, well, Gabi can get audited, and it's not easy to face audit.
Even if we had a local account, having it owned by the corporation or the other legal entity would still probably be better because no individual would be at risk like that.
Exactly.
Yeah, but it was even harder. We tried to do this in the name of using the name of Nesol. The problem is in this country. Well, something similar to what happened with SPI.
It's not unique to this country.
Yeah.
You have to be careful when you're making suggestions about how bank accounts should be set up that you don't display sort of excessive ignorance of international banking law and procedure. It is a real mess. And in fact, even just the trying to get the money to move in one direction across international boundaries into the right place in Mexico has been challenge. And so there are two things I wanted to ask, actually. One, I'm curious to understand why we're talking sort of in the context of creating a new legal organization instead of taking advantage of something like SPI that already exists. Is there a particular reason for that, or is it just generally the idea that there ought to be some fixed organization someplace?
It's generally an idea, and SPI, I haven't considered it because I think it will be a long time until another DEPCON will go to the check for a US organization for that.
Aren't there European free software organizations that can be used for the same in the same way that SPI could be used?
There's the German.
Probably there are some like in Germany, so but they have much broader definitions in there.
There's two sides to the US question there, right? I mean, one of them is what's the likelihood of actually holding it up kind of there. The other one is what fraction of the total sponsorship money is either coming from there or being dispersed and reimbursed on some people from places that it's easier to get money in and out of the US from. I don't know the answers to that. I'm just laying these out as
I think your question should be expanded. So it's quite often difficult to get money out in and out, for example, from Mexico or Brazil. But actually, why does the money that needs to go to buy my plane need to go to Mexico at all? So perhaps there are also some shortcuts that we could take in the future. And if I may allow something else, what you said, if there's some European organization, actually it's in Europe not so hard to establish an organization. I have done that 4 times already, so it's not so hard to make a 5-time one. So I don't think that's definitely necessary to piggyback on existing one. If it would be SPI, of course, we're already piggyback on SPI, so that's a verse.
Regarding SPI, first of all, from my experience, a lot of the sponsors have come from the US or countries for whom getting money to the US is not hard. And certainly the ones I've been dealing with, understandably. But also, it's not too probably well in advance of the next time this relates to DevCon, probably in the next several months. We'll probably sign up with an international payment system called XeTrade, which is actually allows payment to lots of countries in lots of currencies, including the euro and probably the peso. And it actually allows SPI to move money reasonably quickly, easily between countries. So it's not as bad an option, even if it won't be held in the U.S.
As well as moving money around, on the question of liability, it's also mentioned. There's also obviously a lot of issues that come up. If you have a corporation in one country and you want to operate DevCon in another country, you can't go and do that without asking anyone. You do have to get permissions.
And yes, that is the reason why I still do want to have a local thing for the running DevCon, but I want a general thing for the whole DevCon.
I would also question why I think it should be a sort of last resort to have a DevCon specific organization rather than using an existing one, because why do we need to form lots of these things? And if we do, how are we going to decide what the rules of it are? What's the membership? How's it run? How's it represented?
You have a problem because each country that you think about hosting a DevConf in is going to have different rules about not only how you form such organizations, but what the ownership of them can be. And what we're discussing, we have to be careful because there's sort of two sets of things that are being discussed here. One is sort of the overarching organization for the long-term health and well-being of our ability to run conferences on behalf of the Debian project. The other piece is some of your points related more specifically to managing liability for any specific set of organizers of a specific conference and making sure that there's some legal recourse if something horrible happens. And I guess this year we've had a sense that we're not immune to things that so these are all valid concerns, but we probably need to keep clear in our mind that there are sort of different categories of concern here, and it might be possible to address one set of them differently than the other.
I think Murray mentioned an interesting point, and of some examples in Germany where some well-working volunteer organizations try to formalize this process. And later on, they were mainly meeting at CERN with some kind of meta discussions and all that stuff. You might have heard of InterLean or
LinuxTag,
from our proper example. So if we try to formalize something, I would try to make sure that such things don't happen to us.
Yes. The bylaws should be generated over the next weeks or months and should be really well written to mostly avoid stuff. Blas?
One advantage of using SPI or some other U.S. nonprofit corporation for at least our U.S. sponsors, which is seems to be a fairly major portion of our sponsorship, is the nonprofit status. I don't know if we're currently using that, but it may mean we could get a lot more money from the U.S.
We currently the receiving of this sponsorship is not the bottleneck. Usually we look for more sponsors rather than have problems receiving the donor.
If it's a US nonprofit, you can effectively get more money than they're giving you.
Maybe possible, but if you have your own organization,
okay,
someone
from the US, the situation is.
SPI is a certain specific type of nonprofit, which is true for most charities in the US, where donations from US individuals or corporations, not in exchange for some service, are tax deductible, and they give people a break on their taxes, they reduce their taxable income, and that makes corporations in the US more willing to donate to an entity in the US with this status than to a non-US entity, even if it is also a non-profit.
It's also a thought to make if it's an own organization in Europe, maybe to make it a tax deductible thing in the country I'm planning at the moment with it, because it's also relatively easy to do that there.
Yeah,
and you can
comes in Austria, if that's where it is.
And you can also work together with other organizations like SPI, that they get the money and transfer it to the next one or something.
That's not as easy to do. There's restrictions on transferring money.
The problem with non-profits is that you have to demonstrate you're not actually having a profit. That's the problem we have as well this time. That as we couldn't show that the money would be non-profit, we couldn't use it. So that's the reason we ended up using a personal account. Now, I don't think we should form a new organization. I mean, up to this year, because we couldn't handle this as we should, all the countries we have had a debt conflict have some kind of organization that gave us the local legal name. And I think that's the most workable scheme for the future, because maybe we can get an organization. Well, SPA already exists in the US, and we will get something that works. Well, let's hope for all of the European Union. But we're facing, for example, maybe Bosnia, which is not part of the European Union, and the European organization will not work there. And every country we visit that outside this sphere will be the same problem.
I think what Peter wanted to point out, we have to separate the organizational part from the financial part. Mm-hmm. These are two different things.
Yes.
Because for the financial part, it's important that the sponsors have the advantage of tax deduction, no matter where they are.
I want to make a small clarification, too, with regard to the U.S. tax-exempt status and SPI. The first piece is that you must understand that the tax benefit accrues to the person donating the money, not to the organization receiving it. And so the only way it can actually help the organization receiving the funds is if it causes the organization giving the funds to feel more generous. And I'm here to tell you that for a company of the financial scale of HP or IBM or Intel, that doesn't matter at all for the amount of money that we're talking about. I don't think our finance people are even willing to do the paperwork for the amount of money that's involved. It matters a lot to individual contributors. It matters a lot to small businesses that might want to give a few hundred dollars or euros or something like this. And we certainly don't want to discourage things like that. So taking care of the tax status as much as possible in as many places as possible is good. But don't be confused into believing that somehow that magically will get you a bigger chunk of money.
Well, in the UK, it works the way around. I don't think we'd be able to have a charitable organization in the UK because it's much tighter rules.
That's right.
If you could, though, you do actually get more money gets multiplied to the organization rather than benefiting the
Yeah, but as you point out, there's a serious issue there, which is how clients. It's relatively easy to get 501c3 or 501c5 status in the US. It's very hard to get these statuses in other places because of the way it works.
Well, actually, I want to point out that the US works equally well for Germany, and it's also not too hard to get the status. And I think, well, basically, the rules apply for large companies. And another event is about 200 participants also. And for large companies, my experience, they are more interested to get an invoice.
Also, the problem is.
Sorry? And I had another issue that I raised something like 10 minutes ago. That was what you said, we need to make a. We need some local organization, and it's difficult to move away around this one organization. As long as organization is EU-based, and it's the event is inside the European Union, we could move around as well as, I guess, SPI could with the US. I don't know about SPI, but inside the European Union it works anyways. So it might be a good idea, if I look back, so we have last time in the European Union, and we probably have soon another one, perhaps a permanent local one or not.
One thing that I noticed regarding money and storage of money, which this is about, I think.
It's one part of it, but it's not the only one.
There's a huge difference between the Brazilian organization, which got 5 years ago, no, not enough, 3 years ago, I think, a sizable chunk of money and invested that into, I'm not sure, funds, blah, I don't know, and they get excellent interest rates and rates, and I'm not sure how SBI, for example, handles its money.
Can we ever get the money out?
Yes, it happens regularly. We, for example, pay all the webcom attendees.
So we have to answer the question. Yes, SPI has most of the funds in interest-bearing accounts.
And how much?
Just to make a comment. Just to make a comment. That part that we have the money local is the central part, but it's not the only main part of it. I also want some more formalization of the whole DebtConf and the team and the working and more appreciation for the volunteers and stuff like that. It's not only that we have one account for the money where we can get it only, where we can get it all to. It's important to have that, I think, but it's not the only one. Barbot?
On the need of having an organization that Una made, I think we need an organization and not for the money part. We may want to buy stuff like a translation equipment or a machine because this time Una used his personal machines and he lent us his printer and stuff like that. We could have like equipment that we buy and translate from 1 year to another.
Believe me, it's more expensive to ship my printer to Greece. Than to buy
a
calendar.
The printer is a cheap stuff, but more expensive stuff like, you know, servers or give us to have them for multiple conferences.
That only works if you would have the conferences relatively near to each other. Over the half of the world, it's much cheaper to buy or get a new machine from a sponsor. Too expensive to transport the stuff and then to have it somewhere for the whole year until the next DebtConf starts.
I don't really understand this discussion. I don't see a need for it because DebtConf to me is a Debian project. Debian has a legal umbrella. So we can just use this legal umbrella, use the Debian money things which exist in different countries and are done with this both. I agree that maybe there was this discussion, is DebtConf a Debian project or not? And there are some fears if DebtConf is a Debian project, then all people will complain and there will start flame wars, etc. But I don't see, there are other teams in Debian working, the installer team, the kernel team, the release team, and they can take decisions. So there can be a DebtConf team which can take this decision, and of course people will criticize it like every other team is criticized, but also every other team is responsible for their actions.
One difference that we had so far is that we didn't rely on the DPL to okay reimbursements of the huge mass of people. Usually we only had the DPL okay the money that went out of SPI's account.
There have been lots of comments here and in the past about how sort of transparent, reasonable, fair, whatever the right words are, the process of making decisions about who is getting sponsored was independent of how the actual
formal manner, but where the DPL didn't need to send this HTTP signed mail to anyone in order to release the money to the people. But so this is more, of a less.
In this case, Brandon's involvement was more of an SPI board than of a DPL.
And he wasn't invited
because
of
DPL, not because of SPI.
You can also delegate this and say you can spend 100,000 something on sponsorship, and then the sponsorship team can decide exactly the money. The DPL does not have to decide for every 20 euros spent.
But he could even say, it's good for people to decide, but also understand how much gets.
Solima first, he's ready.
I would like to say 3 points. First, as far as I see, DevConf is currently a well-working tool. Okay, we could improve at some points, but it just works. I'm not sure if we really need to change it that much. Two, if you are talking about discussing who is a volunteer, who is an organizer, what they can do and what they are responsible for, I think it will lead to a huge overhead of meta discussion, things we like we really don't need to do, which will draw resources. And third, many of us have their private lives, their jobs, their positions in detail. And every bit of research and every bit of overhead compared to DevConf will draw resources from the Debian project. I don't think we need to do that. I think we must not do that, because DevConf is to support Debian, not to draw resources from them.
And the end is going to be organized by Debian people anyway, so you're going to...
Yes, but currently I don't need to discuss who is a volunteer. When a volunteer starts to be an organization,
I don't want to discuss who is a volunteer or not. I want it like it is now. Everyone here who just started working on stuff is a volunteer, and it should be the same in the next years if we would have such a thing. It should just be a way to be more involved, even for those that only have a few hours left on DevConf or a few hours before that, that they get a bit more appreciation or whatever for it. I don't want to discuss who is a volunteer.
Okay. Do you see it in over? Energy from Debian being sucked into DevConf. Do you fear this if we get a Debian project becomes get the status of a Debian team, or do you think this is a status quo and should be kept?
Yes and yes. Yes, I think we draw some resources from Debian, which could be used sometime else. For example, I haven't read the events and the press aliases for 2 weeks. Just take a quick view if there was something important that Joey has reacted.
But
which
they have more or less anyways. With or without such a thing.
Yes, I see us more as a...
So I'm not really sure I understand what the underlying point is that you're trying to make. I understand the notion of trying to keep the overhead both to individual participants and to the project as a whole running DevConf flow, and I agree. But I'm not sure what you're trying to say about this proposal or about what Andreas has said about
how Stolimar said that constituting another organization on top of what we already have would be overhead. Yet another thing would be overhead, consuming time, not only doing DevConf, but doing
Having already a predefined economical team or a predefined group of people that can handle the money, it's an overhead of having to recreate every time we go to Europe to create a DevConf. I don't think it is an overhead when we have already defined a group of people that can handle all the treasury.
Those are SPI, basically.
Actually,
not.
Aber, erstmal.
The central thing it should be.
The things that I want to say. First of all, the liability thing. If we had, I want to tell a story about an Indian conference where IDG moved in to have a local conference like Linux World Expo, whatever. And they convinced the sponsors of a free conference to not pay the conference organizers the promised money that they actually had spent already in order to bankrupt the free conference. Okay. There was a free conference in India, I'm not sure. Do you know the name? And IDG, the Linux World Expo company, came to India and wanted to take over the market. They regularly do that with conferences, like now and also in Brazil. And they did that in Germany with Linux Tag. There was a conflict there. And they killed off some New York conference,
San Francisco.
Whatever.
And they convinced the sponsors of the free conference to not pay the promised money to, even though they had promised that already and they had calculated with it and budgeted and only waited for it to come to them, so to speak. This is a lesson from that. I want to learn that we must be very careful and conservative with the money that we spend in debt fund in order not to end up with a huge deficit because some sponsor at some point gets a headache or whatever and it doesn't pay up.
Yes.
Usually we have the money in the account before we spend it. And we do this exactly the same way this year.
If I should stick to the order, please I'll do.
And at the moment, who would be reliable? The local ones organizing, if
we,
the right doesn't
get. We don't have a problem because
we don't have a problem yet. But if that would happen to us, at the moment, it would be Gunnar and Gavi that would have the problem.
So we
don't if not,
problem.
Yeah. A smaller problem.
But okay, no more way.
I don't see how this is relating to the big question again, because this is, if you set up a local liability, you need a local organization in the country for that issue.
For
the issue of liability, the only way you're going to solve that is by having a local organization in each country, and in most countries it's quite straightforward. It may cost a small amount, but you can set up a local limited company of some kind to handle to have the liability, and if it goes bankrupt, then that's the company gone bankrupt and nothing else. On the bigger question, I still don't see why we're trying. I mean, there's multiple issues here. There's the issue about money from one year to another, and that of course is mixed up with questions about banking regulations and so on. There's also the question about the running of DevCon from one year to another. On that question, I don't see why it is the right answer to set up a separate organization. And if it is, I would like to know to whom this organization will be responsible. Because then it seems unclear to me why, if we have sponsors who give money to DevConf are trying to help Debian, and if this organization is separate from Debian, for HP, for example, would you rather be giving money to Debian or to some separate organization?
That would be a question for the bylaws part, that you have stuff in your bylaws where you need
a separate organization rather than having it as part of Debian.
Because DevConf is not only run by Debian developers, for example. There are many, many
There's a lot of non-Debian developers involved in Debian anyway.
Are you saying you think that it is wrong for Debian developers and the DPL to have control of DevConf? What do people think? I mean, to me it seems obvious that they should have control, the final control of DevConf.
We have said over and over, and I think it has saved us from quite a few frameworks, that DevConf is not an official Debian project. This, for example, avoided confrontation with
No,
wait. I think that, I mean, we all know we're working, we're doing this so Debian can get better, so we can all meet, but Debian is about making a distribution, not about making a conference. And if we make from DevConf either a Debian project or a group, I mean, like an organized non-profit company or whatever, well, there are many mini DevConfs focused to specific tasks who should be also entitled to take part of the resources we have or whatever. I really suggest not to change the way we have been working so far, because with its good and its bad things, it has worked.
I understand. Okay.
About this? Okay, I have still a question on which matters now fairly well, so I had it some 10 minutes ago. And that's about, you said it's quite convenient that you don't need to go to the project leader for every payment, but that you can just pay the money that you want to. That's appropriate to spend. I have now the question, wouldn't it be possible that the deputy project leader makes a permanent delegation to some people and said, okay, you can spend some money that you got in for a DevCon, for any DevCon purposes?
Maybe possible.
Well, yeah,
treasurer
to that.
That's not an SPI decision, that's a deputy decision. If the money is if the money is related to Debian, which I would, for SPI purposes, I would say for DevConf is not an associated project with SPI, so presumably fall under the Debian heading as far as SPI is concerned. If DPL wants to delegate that to someone, it's not something that SPI is going to overrule as far as Debian's money, unless it's
as a
part of our obligations.
SPI is only concerned in this sort of matter is whether the money is being spent in accordance with the law.
Mm-hmm.
That's
so,
the only
and the project, yeah.
So it would be totally fine with SPI if I and not the DPL came and said, please reimburse
yes.
this
if you are
with the authorization of the DPL.
If I was
a
delegate or whatever.
Okay, fine.
Yes.
One point about liability, forming one kind of company or another in most countries does not set the persons behind that company completely free from all liability if there's any kind of mismanagement or whatsoever. So setting up a company, even a limited company, is no way you're going to get out of all responsibility.
None of or no, but you're more than you are now.
The second point is that I think it would be good to, even if you are a sub-project within Debian, you can be as distinct from mailing lists and so on as you wish. Just request private mailing lists for the team organ, for the organization of the event itself. Communicate outside as much as wish, as is done currently. That should be no problem. I don't think you need an outside legal body for that reason.
Okay, Tonima? Good,
Barbara? I think we've mixed the discussion a bit. First of all, we don't haven't yet determined if we need external organization. And then we mixed if we want that this BSPI or to be another organization, a new one, or some in Europe, or I don't know. I think we mixed, do we need an organization or not? I think we prefer have to determine this if we're going to.
I think yes, that's why I started.
Yeah, but there are different opinions here. Some believe that the local organization must handle everything.
I think it would be a good thing to probably have a few organizations around the world that can be used to redistribute the money. I think we have now run, if I have heard correctly, we have now run two times in a situation where money arrived late and it couldn't be distributed in the way it was originally planned. Which means, with the troubles of transfer money, that you end up with a large pile of money in a country where you don't really want to have it. So it would probably be better to make sure that the money ends up in places where you can distribute it to the people who are going to get it.
And if a large portion of the money is going to travel sponsorship of attendees, it should probably go to the to a place near where they live, so it can be distributed to them directly, rather than hoping that it will be in time in the location of the organization.
That's what we are trying to do. We are actually, for example, in Brazil, we had now a pile of money, and over the last few years, we used that money to pay the
South American.
No, actually, only Brazilian, because Brazil tries to be a very close money market directly within Brazil, so that they can come over at all.
So, is the money actually decreasing?
They have this extremely good fund that they're using, and it's not really decreasing fast as I feared.
So we will be forced to organize another debt fund in Brazil at some point to really
operate.
That's fine.
More money.
Or they can just keep using it to fund the debt companies. They can just keep using it to fund the tickets and any debt from
Brazil. That's also a waste of money.
We tried to work closer together with other bodies holding gambling money worldwide. Unfortunately, no one actually responded to our request, besides FBI and the German.
But for something like that, a more permanent committee within Debian, with a bit stronger organization than it currently has, could possibly help.
So I started to say earlier that with respect to how money gets handled, like SPI and SPI's analogs in other countries, I don't think it matters to SPI whether the DevConf organizing process is a delegated function of the DPL that's treated as being handled from within some specific subset of the Debian funds held by SPI, or whether DevConf itself is an organization that becomes another SPI organization handled the same way the Debian is from the DevConf accounts perspective. The real issue is, what is it we really are trying to accomplish? What do we want that we don't currently have? What doesn't work that might work differently? I think it probably is the case that some degree of either official delegation or organization would help in these sorts of interactions with the other groups around the world that are holding various funds. But I don't personally know how important that is in the global scheme of things. I have intentionally, personally, stayed fairly far from that level of detail in this process.
We have been discussing in the last days, during the times that we spent on the info room with Fabian, Yona, Graham, and usually the Orga team, that one of another is usually there, so we keep talking about the problems that we have this year. This is my first DevConf, and I'm volunteering to help the Orga team. And one of the things that Fabian is taking notes since DevConf 5, and he has very, very good points that repeated this year. So in one of our meetings, he told a couple of things that will happen, and it actually happened. And he's making a good plan for a couple of things, and as we're discussing this, he's not here because he's not feeling well, but probably he would like to, I think that he would like to point that. But one of the things that he outlined is that if we have a two-year line DevConf to prepare from one year for another, like the candidates for the next DevConf should be 2 years ahead, we have time enough to set if we need a local team like Brazil, if we are in a country that doesn't need, we don't need to set up a local team for liability and all that stuff. If we adopt this two-year line, almost all the problems that we're trying to work out here would be solved. Because we have 2 years ahead to get things done. And one of the things that to be addressed, we need the DevConf organization team. But as we discussed, it is one of the questions that Holger needs. Like kernel team, like DI team, like all the teams, DevConf team, and maybe, I don't know if we need a DPL delegation for Andreas or, well, that's another point, but a DevConf organization team that's people committed, even if they have to split a little bit of their work with other male allies, but to take care of looked like that Fabian has a good plan about that. And as he explained to me, he's preparing a couple of notes and a lot of things. I asked Andreas about any other things, going to discuss it, a couple of things that I would like to point as this points that I'm doing right now. So I believe that maybe it should solve the problem. If we like start thinking ahead, 2 years ahead, the problem of getting the organization ready to receive the money and solve all the problems would work very well. So it should be a good outline.
I have another point, Gunnar, that first Stockholm.
I wanted to explain something, so I sort of a fixed point of receiving money could be that could be good. Every year now, I have to send people like HP, for example, a mail or explain to them how they preferably get the money into the country that they where they will need it. And at one point in Brazil, for example, we had problems receiving the money because of some formality errors in the invoice. Since then we were extremely careful to not send formally incorrect invoices, so we kind of learned from that. But still, it's effort to tell people every year from scratch where to send money. Yeah. That for that reason, it would be nice to have only one place for all the time. Then I wanted to explain why SPI why we tried to avoid SPI in the past, like DEPCOM 3 and 4, because it took about a year, to reimburse the last person much more than a year to reimburse the last person from DEPCOM 3, and the DEPCOM 4, the reimbursement process with SPI again lacked very much. This year, actually, the SPI people got their money first, ahead of everyone else. And also last year, it worked pretty smoothly.
It's fixed.
It's fixed. I guess.
Yeah, anyone here wants to become a member of SPI and help. So.
Yeah. Then
all are members of SPI. If you aren't, please go join.
You're all eligible to join if you're a developer.
Or anyone else.
Well,
apart from that, you can join still if you make a contribution to some kind of free software organization.
Yes, but that's not topic here.
The goal was at that point to have a fast, unbureaucratic way of moving money around. Actually, this year, even the ahead of time reimbursement, the money that we needed for the hotel, the $29,000, worked reasonably fast and unbureaucratic with involvements of several people on the SPI side.
Well, bureaucratic, I mean, it was much better than what you described for previous years, but it was still at least 10 days of work.
Yeah,
I would point out that it was actually, at least partially on my advice, much DevConf money has gone not through SPI's hands in the past. I'm here to tell you that I think that's all fixed. So this is why, if we think it makes sense to have a single place as a target for the incoming funds and for us to have control over the international funds transfer processes, I don't think it's a bad place.
And we actually do use SPI heavily for IBM, for Siemens, for I have a list of all the NetApp
for some.
Yeah, a lot of companies in the US.
Could SPIs have a European subsidiary?
We have that already.
We have something similar in Germany, for example.
SPI, historically, it's been hard for SPI to accept donations from people outside the US and then for a while outside the US and Canada. Now we actually can reasonably easily accept credit card donations online from most countries in the world. This is a very new thing. As far as paying money to European debt developers for travel reimbursements, with proper documentation, we should be able to do that pretty easily once we sign up for the service I mentioned earlier, which we'll be doing probably.
Okay, Olga?
There was this argument that DBN is about making a distribution and not a conference, and I think that true DBN is about making it a distribution, but this conference helps making the distribution, so DBN should make DevCon. And the second thing, what I want, I like Fabian's idea about this planning 2 years in advance, because then it's easier to set up local team. I also had the idea of deciding about a backup place to decide another country where we go or place in case we learn that the local team doesn't work. And this year Gunnar said, I think, or you were close to saying Mexico was problematic because of the local team, or maybe I got it wrong, maybe you didn't say it, whatever.
It was problematic because we didn't have a local team.
Yeah, so if we next time...
I put a local team against her will.
So and if we this year decide for a place Foo and then see in a half a year that Foo doesn't have a local team, that we should go to Bar.
It is in second plans also.
Yeah.
They have plans and a lot of other
things.
Really,
I would like to point out also that the Linux Conference Australia people do something that I think we need to copy from. And AJ certainly understands how this works very well. And that is, what's it called, the Ghosts meeting?
The Ghosts Conference Past.
Yes. They have an explicit mechanism for having the organizers of the preceding year and key contributors to all of the previous years sit down with the team that's going to run it the next year and ensure that they understand all the things that need to be done, all the planning that needs to happen, what kinds of things they need to think about. And I think that's something, I believe that's a best practice worldwide conference things that we got to learn from.
That is such a good idea that we had too.
Yeah.
So,
when I was starting, I had some discussion the previous day also, and I had some ideas that we really need to get something which where we can spend money in Europe easily. Now, I learned today that SPI will be able to do it very soon. So, I think we have made a lot of progress, and also I believe it would be that I think SPI is fixed enough. So, I tend now rather to say, okay, we try to get somehow under SPI's umbrella. I personally would prefer it in the Debian project, or is that something else?
I am largely outside of the organization of DevConf, and maybe somebody could sketch how much of the DevConf organization is documented, and also what is the core team of DevConf organization, who does it consist of, what are the roles that are defined there?
DevConf is for you.
Yeah, I started a project on Avios about describing how DevConf works, and I never got further than requesting and receiving the Avios project. but from then on, I also started to pull in more and more people in order to spread the knowledge as well as possible. And I think that works reasonably well. For example, we have some people who are now deeply involved for more than 3 years, like these guys there, or Askigol is not here, and Luciano, and Holger, who has attended several DevConfs, but he was not involved in the organization part. Fabian, yes, Fabian helped last year too.
Gunnar,
exactly. He was involved in DevConf and helped keep
us more discussing. I think it's important for each year to be involved in the previous year conference.
Exactly.
It could be.
The idea is to have the people, all the teams that
there were a lot of minor issues this year.
Actually,
we have put this year lots of stuff into SVN, which will be usable for next year.
We did the first year.
In fact,
you
even more this year.
You were forgetting something, that you did create this task juggler project,
mm-hmm.
which had all the outline for what had to be done by which date. I mean, that was a lot of job that, well, nobody took much care to follow. So the process, or at least the ideal process that was crafted along around November, December, or something like that, exists. It doesn't mean that it was implemented close to it. I mean, it should be interesting to read the file and check how far did we go along those lines, or what happened there. Now, well, what I wanted to say was partly already addressed by Andres. An important problem that we have had is the burnout. I mean, it's very important for people who organize the DevConf, yes, to be involved from before. It's very important not to lose the experience by losing the organizers. I mean, right now we don't have, besides Andreas, anybody who was in the Oslo, or I don't know if you were in the Brazil organization.
No.
Okay, we lost all of them. Yeah. From the Helsinki people, well, many of us stick around, and well, at least I plan on sticking around. So I hope to still be in the core for the next year. The problem is that well, having a local group is not synonymous to having somebody, many people inside the team. For example, well, something that's really encouraging is that over 2 years, well, 3 years if we count Brazil, we have had a large group of Argentinians, and they are planning to do in 2 more years in Argentina, so I think they have a very good experience there. But I counted on having local people getting interested and pulling them to work during the organization process. In the end, I realized that what we need is somebody who can follow the process and explain it to others and take the time to pull people. Because we also don't need too many locals involved in every step of the organization. But for example, 2 or 1 month before the conference, when things start being not planning but implementing, and not projecting but doing, locals are really, really needed. Either locals or a full-time person or both or something like that. So it's not only that we need the people involved. We need the people with the ability to pull more people in.
Yes,
we have one word here from Jesus.
Yeah, just mentioning what BDL and AJ said, that one of their things that we could do is like separate a part of the budget to take all the people that were involved in the organization and then take them to the place that has been decided to be the next host city for the DevConf, and then start checking like 2 months from now or 1 month from now, like go through everything that we suffer in the previous conferences and go through everything that has to be done and has to be budgeted and has to be deadlined to start moving the things on the host city by, so that like the things can get into motion and nothing is forgotten and nothing is just put into the, yeah, we'll do it later, and then never is done.
Would it be too much money?
No.
I mean, it would be very, very important, but it's, I mean, carrying maybe 8 people over the world to see Edinburgh, from there to Brixen, from there to Bosnia, from there to Greece, from there to back to
the
school.
Okay. The one that has been decided.
Yeah.
Okay.
It would be cool.
Okay, stop. Stop, please. We have a time up, so if you want to discuss it, we need to go outside because there's the next talk coming. A very small summarize of this is that we should stay as far as possible in Debian using SPI and other Debian related money things and talk with our DPL for maybe delegation and stuff, but for now we need to finish here.
We have now a meeting about the